Yeah, no, we do definitely want to get out of here. Is there any other information on the Distortion World on, like, how to get out that I know of? Just from the info.
For some reason, you seem to know you're looking for some kind of floating platform.
Okay, so we are definitely looking for something that's floating to flight. Do you have anything that can float that can maybe look up and see if we're looking for...
I think... Can Porygon float?
It can levitate.
It can levitate. So it can fly into the air and give a spot. He suggests that you start heading eastward. Alright.
Okie dokie. So I think we should go that way.
Yep. How do you want to proceed?
Southeast. I think it was heading northwest last I saw.
Okay. Alright.
I think I saw a platform and it was kind of going northwest over that. So we want to go underneath it. And just so I have somebody, I'm gonna. Did my Mario wake up at all? Could it?
You can wake up your Munchie, yeah.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, Munchie will be my out Pokemon.
All right. So, you guys start traveling east.
Dang it.
Okay. Both of you just start meandering east, heading uphill. What seems like a field of like dead plants, until you reach this mountain and this pass north. So, which way do you want to head?
We're supposed to head west, and east. I'm gonna keep going east. Yeah. All
right.
I feel like that's gonna be the best path.
All right. As you start heading up this hill, you hear stomping coming down from the north as this tentacled beast once again starts heading your way. Amber freaks out and tells you to run. Starts running up.
Run, run! Yeah, we're running.
Head up this mountain and you can see... you can see what you can see, essentially. You see what looks like a steep drop to the east, down some sort of path. And you can see north a little bit, and there are these weird, almost cacti-like plants jutting up.
Okie dokie. But there's no floating platform yet, yeah?
Not yet, it seems. Then you can hear foot stomps to the west.
I'm trying to think if there'd be any way to like get down from here.
It's about a like 15-foot drop. You might be able to tumble and make it if you get a really good leap going.
I'm not gonna be around when that thing comes this way. Look, I say we keep going east. Think you can make it?
She looks down and she grabs onto Alpha. Go ahead and make a check.
Oh, 15?
Oh yeah, you make it. Leap down, and Amber grabs onto Alpha, and Alpha just kind of floats her slowly out that way. You hear a roar, and this Ultra Beast starts crashing up, snapping at you guys. But
is that it?
You see a floating platform to the south.
I'm gonna, like, push her. Yeah, push. Go.
You guys push. Give me perception.
16.
All right, you do see this. You find words written in an ancient language that for some reason you can identify. No mortal may act twice in the same way. You guys hop on the platform. It glows slightly, and you shoot skyward, leaving the Guzzlord behind. Right, you are on this tiny little platform, just floating in open space.
I put Lucario in his Pokeball, didn't I?
Yeah, you put him in there before you did that. Good thing, yeah. Too. Check your back, you're still carrying his sword. And as you check everywhere else, you seem to have everything you normally do, including your Pokeball.
I'm going to do an Aura Sense to see what... Just to sort of get a feeling for my surroundings.
You can sense a faint aura coming from the southeast that you recognize, but you're not quite sure whose it is. And you can hear faintly the sound of like dragon fire.
Hmm.
As if you've heard the sound of dragon breath so often that you know when someone is using a breath weapon.
So, I'm going to need to do some jumping. So, I could jump 8.
Yes.
Fuck, I can go all the way, jump all the way to this one then. Do I have to make it? What kind of roll do I have to make?
Just make sure you don't fumble.
Okay.
Oh yeah, you leap and push the one platform back slightly as you Superman your way off and land neatly on another platform. You do start to hear something in the distance, though, almost like a buzzsaw, and it just seems to be cutting through the air, but you're not quite sure where and when it's coming from. Also, you hear a slight you hear the sound of a small poof as the platform you were standing on disappears.
Oh, shit. Okay, I'm going to try and jump to this one over here.
All right, go for it.
Oh. All
right, well, you didn't fumble, so you made it. But just barely, you leap, and as you leap, a small explosion follows you, pushing you just slightly enough to reach the other platform. You grip it as you nearly fall off. Now, in the distance, you see a giant platform. You see it move northward. All right, and now, you finally give me another perception check. 11, okay. That is... no, you hear a buzzsaw flying towards you. As you look to the right, you can see a creature...
Oh, shit.
I knew it would be that one.
...tiny, flying and whizzing past you, and you duck narrowly to avoid it as it just spins by, and then it does a quick U-turn, and that is initiative. You also hear... the sound of a breath weapon coming from the east.
Yeah, I knew he'd be here.
you see Plaid on a platform out with his... One of those as well. However, unlike the one that's fighting you, that one seems to be on the ground. And Plaid just has his Larvesta constantly breathing fire on it. As it just shrieks every once in a while.
Okay, then I will call out Burns.
There we go. Alright. This thing goes wave... Oh, it does not. You go first, excuse me. That's right, your ridiculous speed of 30.
Yep. I will do Dark Pulse.
Oh, nice. You didn't do a ton of damage to it. But
my flinched the bitch.
But you flinched it, yeah. It reels back, caught in a vortex of your dark aura. It's Burns' turn, unless you want to move.
I think moving is probably gonna be the best option at this point, because I had a feeling the platforms were gonna start fucking off, so. Well, can Burns move and attack? Then attack.
He can. He can attempt to make what's called an athletics check, and he can add that on top of his long jump.
Okay, we'll do that.
That is enough to give him one extra more, so he can make a jump.
Oh, yeah.
So he can move there. You notice, though, when Burns leaves the platform, your platform starts to glow.
Hop over to this one, then.
As you leap, the platform you were standing on explodes.
It is Burns. You can't do anything on support for the move.
Or you can take a double move.
Yeah. Yeah, good idea. A double move, what's that?
It's just like it is in Pathfinder. You can give up your standard action to move again.
Okay.
So he won't be able to do an attack, but he can shift onto the platform.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that.
Alright. His platform explodes. You two are now teetering. Kartana seems to have worn off from his dark pulse and looks about ready to attack.
So Cold Charming burns back, and I'm going to make a leap to that big one over here. I think it's in range. Yeah, it's in range.
Okay, yeah. You recall Burns. Make a leap. Just don't fumble. There. Kartana, seeing you float away, starts flying towards Plaid, buzzsawing it.
Now, is this just big because it's in comparison, or is it actually high up? That's why.
It is actually high up, too. It is like at least 10 meters in the air.
Can't just leap to it, then.
Kartana flies towards Plaid and attempts to slice at him. Fortunately, Plaid was ready for that. and ducks, just barely though. And the Kartana passes overhead. Lavi, it's your turn.
I guess I'll try leaping over to this one here.
Okay. Alright. You do?
Oh, okay, do I have to roll it?
Nah, not now. You've done it so often now that it's a little more routine. What are you going to do?
I can't do dark pulse again. Maybe do a double action and move over again?
You can try.
Yeah, I'll do that. Oh. Just move Lavi over to this one.
Alright, cool. Alright, you take a double move. Kartana goes. Knight slashes at him. Sorry, not Knight Slash. He will air cutter. It will hit Plaid for 40, cutting deep into his shoulder. And he gives, it seems like he's about to shout, but kind of holds it in. And just drops to one knee. Yes, it is your go.
I'm going to throw burns out onto Plaid's platform.
Yeah.
Space.
There you go.
Oh, this one's been gotten rid of?
I'm just moving it aside so you can... Because if he's there, he's on the edge.
Okay.
So I'm just moving him there.
I just say because there's an X on him, so does that mean it's been knocked out, or...?
He has been KO'd, but, yeah.
However, Burns should be able to hit that thing with Ember now, if it stays there.
Kartana will, prey, wounded, tries to go in for the kill with his sacred sword. And Larvesta will attempt to intervene, and it will fail.
Oof.
Kartana sharpens to a point, runs forward, and stabs him right in the hip, clean through for 51 damage. Plaid drops to one, on his back, and starts bleeding out. He's now unconscious.
Oh, shit. Alright, Burns will do Fire Fang, I guess. I think it's close enough to do it. Move up and hit Fire Fang.
Yep, go for it. Alright, so even at times 4, it did not do much. Larvesta normally cannot act on its own without a trainer. However, seeing its trainer get attacked, it will flamethrower the crap out of this thing. I'm sorry, it does not know flamethrower. It knows Ember. Or flame charge, actually, yeah. Kartana avoids it.
Oh.
Kartana pulls out, and the blood on its blades just kind of seeps into it. Lavi, it's your turn.
Alright, I want to try something a bit crazy. I want to try and jump over to here. Mm-hmm. But, as I'm sort of jumping over, I want to kind of go for a focus punch on thingy.
Yeah, you can try.
Oh.
Alright, that is a miss. You punch it, and it reshapes itself quickly into blades, and you just kind of punch 5 swords right on their point.
Oof.
You take 3 recoil damage.
Okay.
Kartana buzzsaws once again, and it will Night Slash right through you. Okay, it buzzsaws right past you for 40 damage. 35 for you, since you have that coat.
This guy's fast. If he can keep up, if he can hit me. Burnt is not going to hit Ember.
Yeah, unfortunately, no. That is not enough to hit. Larvesta will do the same with an Ember, doing 4 damage.
Yeah, I have an idea. Lavi's going to hold. I'm gonna hold my action.
Kartana is actually going to air cutter at you.
Okay, I'm going to try and meet it with...
Alright, you don't even need to. It swings wide, and it goes, you duck enough that it avoids it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, air cutter is a ranged attack, and you just...
Let's try that Ember again.
he sets out a bird of flame, but Kartana spins, and just wards it off. And Larvesta is just bad at this. Alright, Lavi's turn again.
Again, on the off chance it might try and attack me close combat, I want to hold my action because there's not much else I can do.
Yep. Its pattern seems to be buzzsaw range. And it will buzzsaw past you again. You can try to meet it.
Okay, now I'm going to try and meet it with a focus punch.
Yep.
Come on.